Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about why I prefer the long haul trucker as a good touring bike, and I'm going to talk about a couple of good features that I personally enjoy about this bike, and I think it's actually very important for anyone that's going long distance, or in my case, that's going cross country. The first thing to take note of is that the wheels are actually 26-inch tires, not the conventional 700cc, like what the Trek 520 has, but that's not a problem. Some people see it as a problem, but it's not at all. Let's talk about a couple of good features on this thing. So, first thing to talk about is the amount of racks you can hook up to this thing. Right now, I only have two, one right here, one over here, and there's another one that's able to get mounted right on bottom right here. These two, I don't know if you can see the other one. Now, I'm getting a frame pump for this thing, so that's why I didn't add another water bottle cage on it yet. But just a couple of three options that you have on here that I think is actually pretty important. It's good to have water with you without having to carry extra on your taking up room in your panniers or anything like that. So this is a long haul trucker. This is the stock saddle. Now, I would recommend you guys do change the stock saddle because, to be honest, it's actually pretty uncomfortable for long distance rides. One thing I would recommend is probably the Brooks saddle that they made from England. They tend to make the best one. I just ordered mine in. It's coming in soon. It's all leather. It needs to be worn in. This rack didn't come with the bike, but it's a pretty solid rack. It's called the Surly Back Rack. It's pretty sturdy. I haven't had a single problem, and they say it can hold up to 50 pounds on top, which is a lot for any kind of gear. And I found that this rack is probably compatible with most of the panniers that I've tried it on, so that's one good thing about it. The brake system on this one is just going to be a simple rim brake. They are pretty responsive, but they're not as good as disc brakes. So if you want something a little bit more responsive braking, I would recommend getting the long haul disc. They made a newer model that has a disc brake, which is awesome. It just happens that I bought this bike before that model came out. Now, my favorite feature on this bike probably be the way you shift gears. So notice the gear knob is going to be over here versus, like, say, right over here, like most road bikes and probably most people are used to. And the neat feature about this one, when everything's in alignment, everything's good, it clicks to change gears, and you know exactly what gear system you're in. And for the most part, it's very spot on, very accurate, and stays in alignment for a long period of time. I haven't had to do any kind of adjustments or maintenance on it since I bought the bike, and I've already put about 500 miles on there. So that's saying something. That's pretty good. Now let's say that you are, biking across country, and your alignment falls, and you're not able to properly shift gears, and the nearest bike shop is about 100 miles away. What you can do, you can take this little knob right here, and then you can rotate it like so, and now you have a free moving lever that pretty much allows you to find the sweet spot. So as I'm moving, let me go to the other side so I can show you guys. Let's do this. So notice the derailleur. As I'm moving, I don't know if you guys can see the derailleur move or not, but as I'm freely rotating the gear, notice you don't hear the clicks anymore. I can find my own sweet spot. So let's look at the derailleur right here. Notice that shift? It allows you to find the sweet spot in your spokes, not any spokes, in your gear to make the proper gear adjustment, which is great to get you to the nearest bike shop. So that's one of my favorite benefits of this bike. And the same thing goes for this system here as well. It allows you to find the sweet spot without having to worry about alignment and doing kind of, maintenance on the road or anything like that. Another neat feature is this right here. It allows you to pick whatever height you want for the handlebars. If you want a more aggressive stance, which I wouldn't really recommend for long distance rides, you can actually take a couple of these rings out, these placement rings, and allows you to bring the handlebars lower. So that's what I like about the Surly, and I highly recommend it. It's been an awesome bike so far. And a lot of people are concerned about speed, and I actually took that for a test drive. And the fastest speed I was able to get on this thing, I was able to pull about 42 miles an hour on a slight downhill, not even big slope or anything like that, but it was slightly downhill. I was able to pull off 42 miles per hour. So it's a great bike for what you're paying for. I highly recommend it. My next video, I'm going to show you how it's, I'm going to compare a couple of panniers for you guys and see what works out best. I already folded out some clothes, and I'll leave that for part two of my video. All right, thank you.